med zero enthusiasts.
Welcome to medical school and welcome to an introduction to suturing.
So, Matt, why do we suture?
Well, Anthony, there's a wound and it's gaping, so we want to close it.
It also stops bleeding, it aids in wound healing, and it may lessen the scarring.
Okay, so what do we need? Let's see what's in our kit.
We have a needle driver,
forceps,
and scissors!
We will also need our suture material.
It's time to begin. First, we'll load the needle. Next, we'll pierce the skin. After that, we'll tie knots. And finally, we'll snip off the ends.
Loading the needle. Use the needle driver and clamp down 1/3 of the way from the base. Have the needle curve point up towards the sky. The U faces up.
If you are right-handed, the pointy part points towards the left. If you are left-handed, the pointy part points towards the right.
Hold up! Before you do that, maybe take some time practicing the clamping and unclamping of your needle driver. Push the circles apart and open the needle driver. Clamp it together to secure it again. Push apart and clamp. Push apart and clamp. Try this until you get the hang of it.
Piercing the skin! Before we do this, decide if you are Team Holes or Team Palm. Whereas many people like to hold their needle driver with their fingers in the holes, some like to take their fingers out and palm the needle driver instead.
For Team Holes, this is how you hold it.
For Team Palm, this is how you hold it.
When we enter the skin, we want to make sure the tip of the needle enters at a 90-degree angle, or straight into the skin. Use the forceps to hold the skin.
As you enter the skin, you want to rotate your wrists, like the changing a light bulb dance move.
Once the suture is through the skin, use the forceps to hang onto the needle as you reload the needle driver.
Enter the other side of the skin and pull through. Do not use your fingers to pull the needle through the skin. Use either the forceps or the needle driver.
If the skin isn't gaping that much and the skin is pretty close together, you may consider piercing both sides of the skin in one single motion.
Time to tie the knots.
For the first knot, do 2 throws or 2 loops and then tighten the knot. Other knots will require 1 throw. So how many knots do we throw? Usually it's about 4 total.
Each time you begin a knot, place the needle driver in between the 2 string ends first. In this position, loop the long end around the needle driver to do the throws. For each knot you make, pull the long end in the opposite direction to where it began.
Let's look at this again to review. Needle driver in the middle. Make a loop. Pull to opposite side. Needle driver in middle. Make a loop. Pull to opposite side.
Once you've done about 4 total knots, cut both ends together with the scissors. 1 suture down.
Now, move about 0.5 centimeter to 1 centimeter away and begin another suture. This technique is called simple interrupted suture, since we are doing a basic knot and snipping each short one at a time.
Once you are done, remember to deposit the sharps in a sharps container and dispose of it according to the City of Calgary guidelines.
And that is the basic technique of suturing. You'll learn more about suturing during a dedicated medical school workshop. Today, let's just practice the technique.
Good luck and have fun!